So in the background there is Willy, our male Galapagos tortoise, only 47 years young. A couple of weeks ago, one of our keepers noticed that he was a bit lame on his front left leg. He was limping a bit, and that didn't go away, continued in fact for several days. And so, of course, we had to get the vets in. When you imagine our boy is nearly 250 kilos, how on earth do you safely lift a tortoise so that you can conduct a series of x-rays? Well, we have a special device we've had made called a hoist.
Got from today. We're now back at the vet hospital and we can look at those on a bigger computer screen than the one that we had down there. So you can see all of those bones. You see he's also got that really thick skin, so you can actually see the surface of the skin. And so you can see all those little toes in there. And then these are the carpets. So this is kind of his wrist. And then this is kind of his elbow joint. And then this is the top bone, so the humerus. So today it was really important to get these pictures of his bones and to know that the bones were all right. And from here we're just going to keep a really close eye on him and monitor his condition, monitor how he is, and we'll go from there. We've been keeping a really close eye on our Galapagos tortoise that's got a sore leg, and we've been monitoring him. He's been slowly improving and slowly getting better, but today it was time for a follow-up check, so we redid the x-rays that we took. So the one closest to me is the one that we took back in March when he first had his sore leg, and then the one on the side is the one that we took today, so we can have them up next to each other and have a look at them side by side so we can compare them. One of the challenges with looking after these tortoises is that they do everything really slowly. So they eat slowly, they move around quite slowly, and they also heal really slowly. So today was about getting pictures of those bones again to make sure that everything's still looking good, reassuring ourselves that a muscle strain or injury is still the most likely problem. So this is about giving him the time that he needs to heal and looking after him in the best way we can while he heals.